Hey guys, it's Anna, and today I'm going to show you how to pull a query for a specific list of students. So I've got a query already pulled up here, and I'm going to click on the Conditions tab. And the first thing I'm going to show you is if your query already has student ID numbers as a condition, like maybe somebody made you a query and they said just paste in your student ID numbers. I'm going to show you how to do that. So this query already has something that says on the conditions tab, student sys number in, and then a list of student ID numbers. So I'm going to pull up my spreadsheet that has my student ID numbers in it, and I want to select all the student ID numbers. Make sure that you don't get any of the empty cells. So you don't want to select the whole column like this and get the empty cells. Make sure you don't get the title at the top of the column. You want to get just the student ID numbers and nothing else. If you have a very big list and it's going to take you a long time to drag, a quick way to do this is to click on the first student ID number in the list. And then on your keyboard, use a keyboard shortcut, Control, Shift, and the down arrow. And what that does is select everything starting from the cell where you are all the way to the end of the data. Then I'm going to copy those. So I'm going to do Control C to copy. And you can tell I copied it because it's got this little dancing line going around it now. And now I'm going to come back over here to my query. To edit this query where the student ID number list is, I'm going to click on it. And it opens up this information about the condition. So the condition is that I'm going to look in student, find the sys number. That's what we call the student ID. And I'm going to only pull ones that are in this list. And here is where my list is. So what I suggest is that you select everything that's already there and hit backspace and then paste in the list that you copied. So Control V to paste and then click OK. Notice when I did that, it bumped my list way off the screen. So now I have to scroll over to see. If you may even open up a query somebody sent you, and it may look like this. And if I click to edit that, I don't see the little box where I paste things in, and that's because I have to scroll over. It's all the way over here. So when you've got your list in there, click OK to save it, and now I'm ready to run that query. Next, I'm going to show you how to do this type of condition if your query doesn't already contain one. Okay, I'm back with a different query, and this time when I clicked on the Conditions tab, it doesn't have a condition for student ID number and a place for me to paste those in. So I'm going to have to create one. Now, first of all, no, you can't create a condition for student ID number unless your query is pulling a student ID number. So make sure it has that sys number here somewhere on the Columns tab. And if it already has that, it should. Click on conditions, and we're going to add a condition here. And if you don't see anything, you can, if this is completely blank, like there are no conditions, you can click the and. But usually you'll see some kind of conditions. Click the little plus to add a new condition. We're going to look in student, and we're going to find the sys number. That's what it's called. These are in alphabetical order. Sys number. And then this is important. Instead of equal to, it should say in list. And then right here, we're going to paste that list. So let me bring my spreadsheet back to the front. Again, I'm going to copy just the student ID numbers and nothing else. Control C to copy. Come back over here and Control V to paste in that value box and click add. And you can see that it successfully added the condition there. And now you're ready to run your query. Thanks, guys. Let me know if you have any questions.